希伯来书第九章。393页。
Hebrews 9, verse 13.
在希伯来书第九章的第十三节。
This is what it says. For if the blood of goats and bulls and the ashes of a heifer sprinkling those who have been defiled sanctified for the cleansing of the flesh.
在第十三节说，若山羊和公牛的血并母牛犊的灰撒在不洁的人身上，尚且叫人成圣，身体洁净。
In Judaism they had ceremonies that they had to do to take care of the sin that they had.
在犹太教里面他有一个仪式，这个祭祀的仪式，这个祭祀的仪式就是有罪的人他要什么呢，他要献上牛羊，然后要洒他的血。
They had to kill animals, their blood had to be shed so that their sin would be paid for.
他们必须要杀这个祭物，把这个血呢流出来，然后呢才洒在有罪的人身上，这个人呢才什么呢，他的这个罪可以得到赦免。
But that only cleansed the flesh.
那这是什么意思呢？杀牛羊只是来洁净人的身体而已。
Having made those sacrifices, bought those animals and killed them, next year they still had to do it again.
今年我买了一头羊，杀了，把这个血放了，我身体上的这个我的身体就得洁净。但是呢，明年这个时候我还要不要？我还要做同样的事，因为我继续犯罪。
But you go down to verse 14 of the same chapter, and it says, "How much more will the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without blemish to God, cleanse your conscience from dead works to serve the living God?"
这在第十四节，就是刚才读的那第后面一节说，何况基督借着永远的灵，将自己无瑕无疵献给神。他的血岂不更能洗净你们的心，除去你们的死刑，使你们侍奉那永生神吗？
You see, the sacrifices that the Jews did was only the cleansing of the flesh.
这些犹太人所做的杀牛羊的这个祭物的行为，只能让他们的身体得洁净。
The cleansing, the blood of Jesus Christ cleansed the conscience, and the conscience is our spirit, our soul.
但是耶稣基督借着那永远的灵，他所献的祭物，他正为上帝的羔羊献了这头祭物以后呢，他可以除什么，洗净我们的良心，洗净我们的心灵。
No, flesh and blood cannot inherit kingdom of God.
这个我们不能凭血肉之躯承受上帝的国。
And we see that in the passage of scripture that you read this morning.
我们今天早上读的这一段圣经里面就已经讲了。
Verse 50.
在哥林多前书十五章的第五十节。
Now I say this, brethren, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, nor does the perishable inherit the imperishable.
在五十节他说，弟兄们，我告诉你们说，血肉之体不能承受上帝的国。必朽坏的不能承受不朽坏的。
Our bodies as they are cannot go to heaven.
我们的身体如果不得到改变，我们的身体就不能进上帝的国。
Because our bodies are mortal.
因为我们的身体是必死的。
These bodies must die and return to dust, the dust that they were made out of.
我们现在所每天精心照顾的身体将都要死去，死去以后都要归为尘土，因为我们的身体从尘土而出。
We need an immortal body to get there.
我们必须要拥有个不再朽坏、不再属地的身体，才能够上天国了。
And Jesus came to die that death.
那耶稣来了是什么呢？是来承受这么一种肉体的死。
You see, that's in verse 3 of the creed. For I delivered to you as of first importance what I also received, that Christ died for our sins.
就像我们刚才读的 这一段，就是这个教会的信条里面讲什么，讲我 当初我所领受又传给你们的是什么呢？基督照经上所说的，他死了，死了又复活了。
Now, from that death, the immortal can emerge.
因为这个缘故，因为耶稣的这个死，那么我们的这个不必死的身体得以有一个机会可以变成不死的身体。
And let's look at John 12.
我们来看一下在约翰福音第十二章。约翰福音十二章的二十四节。
Truly, truly, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains by itself alone. But if it dies, it bears much fruit.
他说：“我实实在，这是在约翰福音十二章二十四节一百八十八页。他说：我实实在在的告诉你们，一粒麦子不落在地里死了，仍旧是一粒；若是死了，就结出许多子粒来。”
You see what Jesus was saying here is that.There has to be a death in, to make it possible for us to get to heaven.
耶稣在这里讲的真理是什么呢？一定得有人死，因为他的死，很多的人可以得生。
But that death isn't a death that is just dead after that, nothing else.
但是这种死呢，不是说像我们这种死，死了就结束了，一个人就死了就消失没了。
There is a life afterwards.
因为呢，死了以后。还有死后的这个永恒。
So now let's look at the resurrection.
我们现在来看一下这个复活的事。
Now, Elijah, way back in the Old Testament,
在旧约圣经以利亚，
God had sent him. There was a drought, and God had sent him to this one lady, and that she would feed him during the time of the drought.
Can you say it again?
There was a drought, and he and God sent him to stay with that lady during the drought, so that she would feed him.
有一个先知叫以利亚，曾经神就差遣这个以利亚，当时那个时候有很大的干旱哦，这个就是灾情很重，耶和华就差遣这个先知去呢，就跟他同住，使得呢他可以去帮助他。
And this lady had one little boy.
这个女人呢，她有一个很小的一个小孩。
And the boy died.
然后这个孩子死了。
And Elijah prayed for the boy, for the dead boy, and he came back to life.
然后以利亚什么呢？以利亚为这个小孩祷告，因为这个孩子死了，然后他就为这个小孩祷告，这个孩子就活了。
Now in the Bible we read that Jesus stopped the funeral.Was coming out of Nain, and told the corpse to sit up.
在那个圣经里面讲说，他叫这个就是叫这个孩子呢，就是从死里面起来。
And then Jairus's daughter, was brought back to life.
然后呢，这个孩子呢，这个女孩子呢，就从这个从死里复活了。
And then Lazarus came back to life after being buried for 4 days.
我们知道拉撒路是在死后四天又被神从死里复活了，就是耶稣叫他从死里复活。
All these people died and came back to life.
这些人都死了，在旧约时候的我们讲的以利亚的故事，然后新约的这两个故事都是从死人从死里复活。
But they all came back into their mortal bodies.
但是大家记住一件事，这些人都死了又复活了，但是他复活以后复活的身体还是什么？还是会死的身体。
Those poor folks, they had to die twice.
这些人其实很可怜，为什么？他们要死两次，他们的肉体要死两次。
When we're talking about the resurrection, we aren't talking about that.
当我们讲复活的时候，我们并不是在讲这种死了活过来，活了又死的这种复活，那不是复活。
Now, Jesus' resurrection was different.
那耶稣的复活是不一样的。
He had been buried.
他呢，死后又被埋葬。
With his back lacerated by the Roman whips.
他的这个被